Hustle and bustle is here, but it's all about one thing, making those holiday memories. And Dr. Sylvie Shuttleworth, chair of the psychology department at Bastyr University, is back with tips to help us slow down and breathe, right, and savor those holiday moments. Good morning, Dr. Shuttleworth.
Good morning. Thanks for having me back.
Sure. So kids are bouncing with excitement, surely, over Santa Claus, and most of us are just trying to get everything done. How can we slow down and help little ones do the same thing?
Yes. Oh, so important for us to slow down and be more present in the moment. Children are actually experts at savoring those moments, and one of the things we can do is try to immerse ourselves in their reality. So sometimes you'll notice a child's just watching a bug walking by on the sidewalk, and can you squat down and be present with them in that moment? Or maybe sitting down and playing a game with them. Children really appreciate that when we give them our unfocused attention. The other piece in terms of being present and slowing down is for us to think about having them share in our experiences. Maybe we can delegate a task to them around the holidays so they feel important and they feel more involved, or maybe sharing a story together. One of the pieces that can be really helpful with kids, particularly this time of year, is to make sure they're getting some exercise and some movement to help manage their emotions. Because this time of year brings up a lot of feelings for folks, especially adults. And maybe I could speak to that for a moment. For us as adults, making sure that we're aware of how we're feeling and being able to communicate that to our loved ones and letting them know how we can be supported by them. That can help us to recenter ourselves as well.
Absolutely. Thank you for mentioning adults, because we ourselves are going to be a little bit frazzled. How can we sort of take a moment ourselves to make sure that we are enjoying the moment as well?
Yeah, I completely relate to that. I've got three little kids at home, lots of holiday guests coming, and I have to remind myself, like, how am I going to stay centered? So one of the things is, it can be difficult, but trying to let go with the flow and be flexible. No one's going to remember that things were just so, or that you checked everything off on your to-do list. What they're going to remember is how they felt in your presence, how they experienced your energy. So being aware of that. One of the things that I do sometimes is I'll actually take a pause, I'll take a breath, and the house is full and there's people talking and kids playing, and I'll watch it all happening. And I'll tap into my five senses to more solidify that memory. So I'll take in the smells, I'll take in what I'm seeing and the sounds. And if you have that pause, it can help to recenter yourself and fill you with joy to pay attention to what's happening around you.
I think it's such great information, because we get so carried away, right, with everything that we need to do. We also want to cherish some new memories. What can we do to instill memories in our children and with our guests that we may have over?
Yeah, great point. So I think those traditions and rituals that we might have around this time of year can be really powerful. And what those also do is they, again, help us to be present in the here and now. We do know, research has shown us, that if, as human beings, we're too focused on what's already happened, what's in the past, that can bring up feelings of sadness and maybe depression. And if we're too focused on the future, that can bring up a lot of anxiety for us. So traditions and rituals can actually help us to be in the present moment. And then once you do those experiences with family, with friends, a beautiful activity is actually to ask, what was your favorite part of that? What did you like most? And then you start telling stories about it and instilling those memories filled with joy. And then that can help our overall mental health and wellness, and to help us to be more happy, present, joyful individuals.
Such great information. Dr. Shuttleworth, thank you so much, as always, for joining us on this. We appreciate your insights.
Absolutely. Thanks for having me on.
Sure. We'll be right back after this.